Let us start with question number one. Can you read the question?
Yes. Represent the following numbers on the number line. First part is 11 upon 4. And 11 upon 4 would be 2, 3 upon 4.
Okay, this is 2, 3 upon 4. So why you are converting into mixed fraction?
So because then it will be a whole number and the number line is composed of whole numbers.
And see, yeah, this part is absolutely correct, but what about exactness? You're just giving it a approximation, isn't it?
Yes. So do we put like four divisions upon like
yes.
between all the numbers? Okay.
Yes. One second. I'll show you in one question. Okay. Let me just draw a straight line. Okay, there should be arrows on both the ends. Okay, I'll draw a line. Okay, is this thing fine?
Yes.
Okay, this part is absolutely correct that it should be 2, 3 upon 4. So,
yes.
Let us do one thing. Let us, because it is a positive, so there is no need of negative. So, I'll start with 0. I'll take a proper gap. 1, 2, you should take equal gap, okay?
Okay. So I took a gap of 1 centimeter between all the ones.
Centimeter. That is fine. So this is 3 upon 4. That means 2 and 3 should be divided into 4 equal parts. So how many lines will I put?
4.
No. If I have to divide
Okay.
I have to divide one log. Okay, you have one, suppose you can say a chocolate. Okay, you have one chocolate. You need to distribute into 4 pieces. So
yes.
How many cuts you will make? That question I am asking.
Okay. So
one cut.
Three cuts.
Very good. Okay. Is it making sense?
Yeah.
So basically,
so you put three.
1, 2, 3. So that means there are 4 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. So these are the 4 equal parts.
Yes. And the and the fraction. And the fraction will go on the third equal, the third part.
Yeah. One second. Yeah, I need to erase only the top portion. Yeah.
So do I make it again or do I just add the equal parts there?
Right now you just add it over here only, but you need to do a few questions. Okay, let me just circle it. This is 2, this part is 2 1/4, this is 2 1/2. Oh, sorry, 2/4, and so the answer is this one. This is 2, 3/4, or we can say this part is what? 4/11.
Okay. Yeah.
And you should draw arrows that you have already done. This is fine. So do one thing. Do the correction of the first question, first three parts. Okay, and send it to me just right now.
Okay, sir.
So let us focus on the second part, 4, 3/5. So this is good that you have taken it as a Q. So on the number line, 4, 3/5 will be between 4 and 5. Sorry, 4 and 5, not 4 and 4. Yeah. So 4 and 5, you have split it them into 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I just wanted to show another method. We'll show it in the next question. This is fine. So you have put arrows. That is also good. So let us move on to the next third part. Third part is negative. So yeah. So see, isn't it looking very untidy?
Yes. No, so I thought you had to... When I did it later, then I thought that you had to put it between all the numbers.
Yeah, that is better. So I'll just show you how to do it. Since it was 9 upon 7 only, so we could have directly done that. So we have to understand when to use this kind of method. Sorry. When to use this kind of method and when to directly plot. So when the numbers are very far away from 0, na? So we try to use this method. When the numbers are close by, so then we do it directly. How to do directly? So that means the gap between the number is getting divided into here 5 equal parts, here 7 equal parts, isn't it?
Yes.
So we know this is a negative side, so we should move this direction. So we are starting from right end. So let's say this point is 0. So we try to do it like this. This become minus 1 upon 7 directly. Okay, this become minus 2 upon 7. This become minus 3 upon 7. Similarly, 4 upon 7, minus 5 upon 7, minus 6 upon 7, minus 7 upon 7. And this point is minus 1. And this is minus 8 upon 7, minus 9 upon 7. Minus 10 upon 7. So this point, so we will circle this point as Q. That's how we do it.
Okay.
Okay. So
that's also what they've done in the second question.
Yeah. So, yeah, this part is absolutely correct. I'm not denying that, because going 4, 3 by 5, and if I convert it into improper fraction, that will be 20. 3 upon 5. That's very far away, isn't it? Making 23 times like this. It's very time consuming. So instead of that, this method is better. I'm not denying. But it was only 9. Isn't it? 1, 2, 3.
But this only applies. But this only applies to like one. It's like a improper fraction.
Yeah, improper fraction. Yeah, that's perfectly fine. But if you look at the first question, you did it in a different way. It was improper, but you converted into mixed fraction. And that is also fine. And both ways are equally correct. Having said that, neatness is important.
Okay.
Hope you do the third part again later on as homework. Okay, so let me just check the last part, fourth part. Okay, so both were negative. So first of all, write the question like this. Don't cancel it here only. Okay, minus 2 upon minus 5 equals to 2 upon 5. So that means that is only 2 upon 5. So there was no need of doing these many things. Okay, we could have just done. 2 upon 5 is very close by. 0, 1 upon 5, 2 upon 5, 3 upon 5, 4 upon 5, 5 upon 5. It was very near. It was a proper fraction. So you could have just circled this thing. That's it. This is the answer. Isn't it neat?
Yeah.
So.
And it's also easy.
I understand that you are trying to divide whole number line into 5 equal parts. I'm not, if I am a teacher, I have to give you marks. But it is not neat. I'm not happy.
Okay.
So make sure you do third part and fourth part again.